Hello from Tokyo again. Today I decided to wear my mask on the train so that I wouldn't scare people. But then I realized if you wear a mask and you wear earbuds, you can pretty much just keep to yourself, check out. Nobody will talk to you. You don't have to talk to anybody. So if you're introverted like me, it's perfect. You don't have to talk to anybody. But anyway, today I'm going to give a lecture on the sheer behavior of concrete. But before I do that, just talk a little bit about some of the things here in Japan. One of the cool things in Japan is that they are really into pens, pencils, and stationery and that sort of stuff. And so I've got some stuff here. There's a disposable fountain pen that you can buy. It writes pretty well. Got this little pen here. It's got like red, blue, and a pencil. So sorry, it's got red, blue, pencil. I've got this fancy mechanical pencil. And then when you write, the lead automatically rotates while you're writing, so it always stays sharp. this fancy little portable stapler. I don't even know how this works. Anyway, this opens up and it's a stapler. I've also got a stapler that doesn't use any staples. That's a little crazy. It's one of my favorite things. It's a four-color erasable pen. So I can write in four different colors, like a big pen, but it erases. speaking of erasers, this is a pretty cool eraser. It's white on the inside, blue. And so when you erase, eventually you can make it look like Mount Fuji, like that. And the real reason I'm talking about this is, so here's a little portable scissors that goes along with my portable stapler. And you take it apart. I actually had this in my backpack on the plane. I forgot I had it, and it made it through TSA. But yeah, there you go. It's a little portable scissors. And the reason I want to talk about that is I want to talk about how scissors work. So what I'm going to do, so here's a piece of paper. I'm going to cut a pair, I'm going to cut it right like that. Okay. And so how it works is there's the scissors, right? Right there, and it goes like that. Okay. And I don't know if you've ever thought about what scissors are doing, but they're basically doing this. Yeah, that's what a scissor does. And what it's doing is it's shearing through the paper. In fact, if you buy scissors that can cut tin, they're called tin snips, or sometimes they're called metal shears. And so these scissors will shear the paper like this. And today we're going to talk about shearing concrete. So keep that in mind. This is shearing. And we're going to talk about shearing of concrete, reinforced concrete, that is. Okay, so what I'm going to do is I'm going to share my iPad, and I'll continue the lecture on my iPad. Okay, share my iPad. Let's see. There we go. Okay. We're all set. You don't need to see me while I'm doing this. Okay, so here's a beam. So there's a beam. And like the scissors, you want to shear it like this, okay? But unlike a piece of paper, it is not going to break like this. Concrete does not shear like this. Okay? So the scissors will shear a piece of paper just like that. But what happens in concrete, so let me move the loads farther apart. Okay, so you're trying to shear it. what's going to happen is that the more circle for pure shear looks like this. Okay, there it is. That's pure shear, more circle. And we talked about this in reinforced or in the civil engineering materials class. The failure envelope for concrete looks something like this. And so when the Mohr circle hits the envelope, it'll break. So it's getting bigger and bigger and bigger, and eventually it will hit the envelope and break. This point here is shear. That point there is tension. And what this means is that you can never actually shear concrete like that. It'll break in tension. And the tension happens at 45 degrees from the shear, because on the Mohr circle, it's 90 degrees away from here to there is 90 degrees, but remember it's two data. And what that really means is that this little block is gonna break at 45 degrees like that, because those two forces add up to a force like that, or those tractions or stress. And you break at 45 degrees. So when you break concrete, when you shear it, it's gonna crack at 45 degrees. And that crack is gonna go like this. And then when it breaks, it wants to do this. Going up, and this side wants to come down like that. Okay? So that's going down, that's going up, and that's how it's gonna break. Okay, so that is what happens when you shear a concrete beam that doesn't have steel. So how would you make the right half stop from falling down relative to the left half? What you would do is you would tie something like this, a piece of steel. Okay? So that would hold the bottom half to the top half. And so what this looks like, okay, so let me draw that. Here's the potential shear crack. You want a piece of steel that goes across a crack. And what that's gonna look like, okay, from this side view, that steel often will look like this. That looks like a stirrup, sort of, on the bottom of a saddle where you put your foot in, okay? And what that will do, this part here will be in the top half of the beam, and it'll hang down to this part here, which is in the bottom half. And if it goes across there, it will hold the beam together. So the strategy is, if you don't want your beam to shear apart, so let's draw a beam, you have to put these stirrups in there. Now, I think you can see, or it makes intuitive sense, that the closer you put these stirrups together, the stronger they are. And if you make them farther apart, they're weaker. So what you wanna do is, where the shear is high, you wanna put the stirrups closer together. And if you remember what a shear diagram looks like for this, there you go. So out here where the shear is high, you want the stirrups spaced closer together. Okay. And over here in the middle where the shear is low, you're gonna space them farther apart. So that's what the shear will look like. Now there's a lot more things to talk about in the behavior of shear, and we'll get to those details. But this is in a nutshell how you would reinforce a beam to stop it from breaking in shear. We'll cover the other details when we get to the shear chapter. So that's it for now. It's funny how you see me at the end of these as I turn everything off, but I'm just too lazy to go and edit the ends of these clips out.